In this video, I want to talk about how to deliver treats properly, how to hold them in your hands and to deliver them properly into your dog's mouth without getting your hands bit up, without dropping the treats, and to do it most effectively. To show that, we're going to use our young dog, Dwayne, the Dwayne-o-mater, and show you some of this. So Dwayne, good boy. Remember, always start with your dog when you're doing any training on a long line, and you see he's kind of getting jumpy. Good boy, right? And the main thing I do is I always try to deliver very small treats, about that size, and I try to deliver them, if the dog is in front, from this kind of a position. So I almost call this like a shovel position. The treat is here. I push it into the dog's mouth. Now, Dwayne is taking the treats really hard, so he's biting on my finger. What most people make the mistake of doing here is they say, hey, easy, hey, easy, hey, easy. And what that does, it creates a chomping action for the dog where he wants to bite harder on the treat. He wants to get what you're taking away. And it's initiating his prey drive, really. What I want you to do in this case is be able to hold the treat in front of him and say, no, good, easy. And when I deliver the treat, I want to take the treat and push it into the dog's mouth. So here I go, easy, and I deliver it. So one more time, Dwayne. Easy, and I deliver it. By doing that, it creates a reflex in the dog, and the dog's head, you're going to watch, is actually going back to take the treat. That's going to soften his mouth. If a dog is lunging forward, that's going to create a biting like that, a biting movement like that, where he's going to get more chomping on your fingers. But by pushing the treat into his mouth and using a word like easy or gentle, teaches the dog that when that word comes, the next thing that's going to happen is this pressure is going to come forward into the dog's mouth. So if I say easy, easy, now I can say easy. See how his head went back? When I deliver the treat forward, I say easy, and I don't give him the treat until he starts to kind of go backwards and taking the treat. Easy. And now he's taking the treats much easier. Remember, by pushing the treats into his mouth, it creates that opposition reflex where he moves backwards, and it's naturally forming that habit of easy, of taking the treat easy. Because you can get really chewed up on your fingers here with especially young dogs, puppies, who still have their puppy teeth. He doesn't have his puppy teeth anymore, but he's still kind of really excited to take the treats, which is nice. You want a dog that has nice drive to take the treats, but it's going to be kind of a pain in the neck when you start to get eaten up. Some people will tell you just to hold the treat until the dog softens their mouth and then give them the treat. But certain dogs, higher drive dogs, sporting dogs, working dogs, a lot of the shepherds, will start to push harder and harder for it, and you're not going to get anything out of it. The other thing, when I use this long line here, when the dog gets really jumpy for the treat, he gets a natural correction because I'm just standing on this line and he can't really get to the treat. So here, easy. So if he starts to jump up, which he's not doing now because he's got a couple corrections on this, I just kind of stand on this line. I don't want the dog jumping in my face to get the treats because it creates a really uncomfortable habit where the dog is clawing up on top of you. If you're going to train a protection dog, you want that drive. But with just a nice obedience dog, you want the dog to have good manners, to sit in front of you, that's a good boy, Dwayne, and take the treat nice and easy. And remember, in the beginning, always push these treats back into the dog's mouth so that the dog will start to take the treats a lot easier. That's really, really critical. So, that being said, a lot of people will do a lot of the obedience here. They'll say sit and come and down and all these different commands. But that's only in this position. We need to have another way, a second way, to deliver the treats if the dog is next to us or behind us. And the way we do that is we take our hand and we turn it back this way. So my hand is now facing the dog, as you can see. So from the dog's perspective and the camera's perspective, I'm holding the treat here. So you might want to get a really good shot of my hand position here. My hand is cupping the treat, and this is a little piece of lamb jerky. It's cupping the treat between my thumb and my middle finger, and I use my index finger to push the treat back. And a lot of times you'll catch me doing this technique where the treat is lengthwise in here, and I'm using this to kind of almost push it through like a Pez dispenser. It keeps adding more and more and more treat to it. So that's a really good technique that if the dog here, Dwayne, If the Dwayne-o-mater is taking the treats like this, that I can keep pushing the treats in and giving him more and more treats as I'm going forward on the treat. I can have one nice piece of either hot dog or jerky or string cheese and continue to feed it to him in that position. It keeps coming forward and forward until eventually I'm out. I do not like the technique of keeping your hand closed like this for the dog, because it doesn't give the dog any intermittent rewards. So in other words, right here, the dog is nibbling, and I can kind of control it and pull it back from here and give him. But if he starts to be pushy with the treat here, I can push him back and say, easy. And you see what he did? He took a nice relaxed position. That's a very good boy. And then he's going to get his treat. Remember, you want to get your dog to take treats very easily from your hand. You don't want the dog to get really pushy and biting on your hand and getting what we call hard mouthed. If he gets hard mouthed, it's a very hard habit to break. And later on, as the dog becomes more stronger in his age, he's going to start to get more mouthy, and then you're going to start getting more injuries. You're going to get bites and stuff like that. And it's not comfortable for anybody. So remember, everything with the dog, the treats, I have the treat, I control the treat. Even in this position, he's not going to jump up and get that treat from me because he knows he has to wait for it. Then I tell him that's a good boy. I give him the treat nice and easy. I deliver the treats, easy, good boy, easy, good boy. And when I want to get him in positions, I can lure him by using a longer piece of treat and say, come on, Dwayne, here, and getting him in a nice position. I control the treats. This is real important that he learns this early on here, that I control the treats. If I take the treat away, he doesn't get it. I give it to him, he gets it. I take it away, he doesn't get it. This is a really good delivery system, because at your hip, you can see that I can now gently start to walk with the dog here, right, and carry him all the way around, easy, and keep his focus. You won't get this when you start to deliver the treats this way, and this is a big mistake people make. They deliver the treat this way, and now you have a crooked heel. You can't do any technique with the dog next to you if the dog is starting to come to the front. And the more he gets to the front, the less ability you have of keeping him in that heel position, which is really where you want him. So the treat here between my middle finger and my thumb, and I can push it and I can get him in a nice position. I can lure him, and all this technique, this hand here is cupped this way. And another really important thing is if you're working your dog next to you, you're working on a heel or something, try not to deliver the food from here, because it's going to make this heel crooked. And I'm going to talk about that in another video. What you really want the dog to do is to be in this position, and ideally you almost want to focus on the dog's heeling being this way, so that his head is canted to the left outside quite a bit, and his food delivery here, as you can see, his turns are all to the left, which is what is going to keep his body perfectly straight, right? So you see here his body is completely straight where I want it, whereas if I had his body here, or the treat here, his body is crooked. So delivering the treat from the proper angle can mean all the difference in how the body of the dog is going to be on you. So tilting his head out slightly, and again, I've got the treat right here, tilting the head out slightly is going to straighten this out. And again, I'm going to talk about that more in our heeling videos, but right now, this is important that you understand your treat delivery system here is just like that. And adding to that, one last thing, when I put the dog and work downs with my dog, I'm going to hold the treat the same way, this kind of shovel position, and come down with him here. And here, I'll still tell him easy, easy. And now you can see how much easier he's taking the treat when I say easy and deliver the treat. So the whole technique there is going to look like this. It's really important that when you say easy and he eases up on it, that he gets a treat. If not, you're going to build a crazy amount of frustration. So if I have him here and I say easy, I immediately give him the treat when he does easy. I don't want to say easy and then withhold the treat. So it's easy, he eases up and he gets the treat. And that's one good technique, or a couple good techniques, on how to deliver treats to your puppy who might be a little bit crazy like the Dwayne-O-Mater. And we want to thank you for watching this video. And if you liked it, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and give your dog every opportunity for good training, a happy life, good structure, because it's going to mean that he's going to be with you the rest of his life and not end up in a shelter or displaced or living in the backyard where he shouldn't be. He should understand you. He should get the structure he needs to have a happy life. And so you can handle him and you can enjoy him the rest of his life, because that's what we want. Right, Dwayne-O-Mater? Right, Dwayne-O-Mater? That's right.